In this video, I'm continuing on with the line segments and measure worksheet on the KutaSoftware website. I'll leave a link in the description below so you know how to access this worksheet. And for this worksheet, we are dealing with inches. For our next set of directions, we're supposed to use a ruler to measure the length of each line segment, and we're going to measure each segment in inches. Next, we're going to round our measurements to the nearest eighth of an inch, just like we did in the previous part of this worksheet. However, now, as opposed to just measuring, we're also going to state the maximum error and the maximum percent of error in each measurement. So let's go ahead and start with number 15. Number 15, when I line my ruler up, you can see that it falls at 1/8, 2/8, 3/8, 4/8, 5/8. So it falls at 2 5/8 of an inch. So that is my measurement. Now, our next step is to state the maximum error. If we're measuring to the nearest eighth of an inch, our maximum error is going to be 1/16 of an inch. When you're rounding to a nearest whole number, you're rounding anything from 0.5, you round up, but anything less than 0.5, you would round down. So your error for if you were measuring to the closest inch would be 1/2 inch. Your error for measuring to the closest 1/4 inch would be 1/8 inch. So your maximum error for rounding to the nearest 1/8 inch is going to be 1/16 inch, 1/2 of that 1/8. So now that we've stated the maximum error, we need the maximum percent of error in each measurement. The maximum percent of error is going to be the max error divided by the measurement. That will give you your maximum percent of error in the measurement. So on my calculator, I'm going to type 1/16, making sure that's in parentheses, and then I'm going to divide that by 2, and so adding 5/8, and that's going to give me a decimal, 0.02, rounding to the nearest thousandth, 0.024. So converting that to a percent, we would get 2.4%. Now let's look at number 16. When I measure number 16, you can see that to the nearest 1/8, I get 1/2 inch. And then since we're rounding to the nearest 1/8 inch, our max error is 1/16 inch. And now let's enter that into our formula. Max error divided by measurement equals max percent of error. So I'm going to do 1/16, and I'm going to divide that by 1/2 to get 0.125, which would be 12.5%. And number 17, I'm a little short of an inch, so I'm going to say that this measurement is 7/8 inch. Our max error, since we're rounding to the nearest 1/8, is 1/16 inch, and then we're taking 1/16 inch and dividing that by 7/8. So 1/16 divided by our measurement of 7/8 equals 0.0714, so 0.071, which will be approximately 7.1%. Next, number 18. When I measure this, I get about 1 1/4. So this is 1 1/4 inch, so 1 1/4 inch. My max error is 1/16 inch since we're rounding to the nearest 1/8. So on my calculator, I'm going to have 1/16 inch divided by 1 1/4 inch, making sure to have parentheses since I'm adding in that denominator. And that's going to give me 0.05, which rounds to 5.0%, or 5%. Number 19, my measurement is a little less than 5 inches, and it's about 1/8 inch short of 5 inches. So that's going to be 4 7/8 inch. My maximum error is 1/16 inch. When I type this into my formula, 1/16 inch divided by 4 7/8 inch, I get 0.0128, which rounds to 0.013, which is approximately 1.3%. And number 20, when I measure this line, I get 5 1/8, 2/8, 3/8. So 5 3/8 of an inch. My max error is 1/16 of an inch. So when I type that into my calculator, 1/16 of an inch divided by 5 3/8, I get approximately 1.2%. And something to note, if you can see, as my lines are getting longer, my maximum percent of error is getting smaller. So the shortest, number 16, half an inch, I had a 12.5% error, but then you can see with my longest line, number 20, I only had 1.2%. Why do you think that is? Leave it in the comments below. Next, we have our critical thinking questions. Jessica measures a line segment to the nearest 1/8 of an inch. She calculates that her measurement has up to 0.1% error in it. What measure did she find for the line segment? So remember our formula, we use the max error divided by our measurement was equal to our max percent of error. So let's plug in what we know. We know our max error, since she's rounding to the nearest 1/8 of an inch, is going to be 1/16 of an inch. So we're going to have 1/16 of an inch divided by our measurement, which is our unknown, and that's equal to 0.1%. However, we need to convert this to a decimal, so we're going to move it over 2 to the left to get 0.001. So 1/16 divided by our measurement gives us 0.001. So treating measurement like a variable, say this was x, we would multiply both sides by x to get it out of the denominator, and then we would divide, since we want that x by itself, by 0.001. So ultimately, 1/16 will be divided by 0.001, and you can see that will give us 62.5. So her original measurement was 62, changing 0.5 into a fraction, and 1/2 of an inch. Number 22 asks us, what is the minimum error and minimum percent of error in Jessica's measurement? Well, assuming that she is accurate, her minimum error would be 0 inches. If she was right on that mark, so the minimum error she could have, assuming that she is correct, is 0 inches. So her minimum percent of error would also be 0%. So if we took her minimum error and divided that by our measurement, 0 divided by any number is 0, so 0% would be the minimum percent of error. And that wraps up the line segments and measure worksheet using inches. Please remember to like this video and also subscribe to my channel.